So today I'm going to talk about the exact mechanism that locks up the ankle, how it really works. Nobody, no doctors, or no kinesiology professors will explain this to you the way I do, because they overlook something, which is very important, the function of the retinaculum, which is the band that wraps around the area of the shin and all the way to the heel, this band. So the way it works is, you see all these tendons, right? I mean, if you understand this, please try to explain to your friends who have ankle sprains, who have chronic knee problems, chronic foot problems, you know, always perform subpar in athletics. This is something that we've done to ourselves. You know, we look at LeBron James, we look at Kevin Durant, all those super athletes, and we think, wow, they're a different species. But no, they are the same. They have been doing something that helped them to be athletic. But regular people who are brainwashed to believe that the shoe is the best way to go, still use a neutral mode of the foot, and the nerves in the foot degenerate over time, and they become sick, and they don't even know it. And they have all these lower back problems, you know, just sitting down, because their glutes are not working. So if the glutes is not working, then the weight is going to go somewhere, right? It's going to go to your lower back. So the way that it locks up the ankle, it's really because of the anterior tibial tendon, all these tendons in the front, okay? Because they are underneath this sheath of ligament that we call the superior and inferior retinaculum, when this tendon pops to the front, pops out, right, it stretches this ligament. So this ligament, because it's attached to your heel, because it's also attached to the upper level of your shin, it locks up the ankle. So the tendon underneath this retinaculum makes this retinaculum sheath ligament go up, and when that happens, it puts tension in the retinaculum that locks up the ankle. Okay, like I've seen the Tim Grover from Attack Athletics, and what he has people do is get a band wrapped to your ankle and just do ankle extensions or from the side. You know, that doesn't really do anything to ankle sprains. That doesn't strengthen the tendon. The only way to strengthen the tendon and the ligaments is by using the hyperarch mechanism and the technique we talk about in the book. So this is another picture, right? Some other person asked me a very good question. How does it build nerves? You see these posterior tibial nerves? They are very closely attached to the tendons. So it's almost as if you have a tendon, you have all the tendons that you have, they're very closely tied to the nerves. So if you're actually using the tendons properly, these nerves will be stimulated, and because it has this all the way travels all the way up through your underneath the muscles and tendons all the way up to your glutes, and that's why we need to use these. And these are actually inside the foot. That's what we concentrate on, the hyperarch, the arc, not toes. I mean, toes is one aspect of it, but it's not just the toes. And one of my favorite players is Allen Iverson. Look how prominent his tendon is, and this is just in the neutral mode. Over time, another important property I discovered about the foot is it has the ability to morph, and also it has this property of plasticity just like our brain, which means, you know, over time under tension it will change shape and it will change its purpose. So look at this tendon here, this big anterior tibial tendon, and it's going to be very hard for him to have an ankle sprain if he doesn't have to be cognizant of the foot. The way he performs is he subconsciously uses the mechanism. People that are trying to improve their biomechanics, trying to improve the way they move around, they need to be very cognizant about their foot. That's how we build it back, because the shoe has deteriorated the way you move, the way you take a jump shot. It's just wrong. The way you run, many people cannot even use glutes when they run. It's all quad. They get tired so easily. But we're only using 50% or less of our body because of this. Now, this is another picture of this same thing I'm trying to talk about. In fact, if the tendons of in the front, in the shin that connect to your toes, and all these tendons, if the way the biomechanically, if this tendon is actually above the sheath of retinaculum, there will be no way to lock up your ankle. The design is of the foot is so good and so interesting and so complex, you know, which I just find to be, you know, it's super interesting because I'm a big nerd. Okay, this sheath of that wraps around your tendon, if this sheath is underneath your tendon pop up, it does nothing. Your ankle won't be locked. The reason that your ankle will be locked via the hyperarch mechanism is because when you put tension in the foot, in the tendons, it pops out all these tendons in the front. When it does that, it stretches the band forward, okay? This band up forward. And that pulls your heel, that pulls your bone to the foot and locks it up. No more ankle sprain ever again. Just be cognizant of your foot. Now let's look at a real life example, okay, of LeBron James. LeBron dribbles the ball, boom! He made a skid mark on the floor, and everybody's like, "Ah, he's made skid mark, you know. So what? It just looks funny." But look at the slow motion of exactly what happened. Okay, this is, when somebody make a skid mark like that, there's a lot of friction, a lot of force. But did he have an ankle sprain? No. So let's take a look. Oh, he was in the awkward position and sliding on the floor for a second, and yet there is no twisting. That just shows how strong his foot is, and that gives him this athletic ability. Let's take a look again. No ankle spray. He's okay. He's fine. Alright, I hope that's helpful. If you understand my explanation, try to give me a like. Try to share the video.